everyone, my name is Minty, and in this video I show you how to use MIDI with MiniFuse 2. Let's get into it. MiniFuse 2 comes with a MIDI input and output, so you can use it to connect your MIDI devices to your software. Let's first take a look at how to control hardware from your computer using MiniFuse 2. To begin, we'll need an external instrument like MicroFreak, a 5-pin MIDI cable like this, our MiniFuse 2, and a computer with a DAW installed. We'll be using Ableton Live. First off, let's connect the instrument's audio output to the MiniFuse audio input to enable flow of the audio signal. Then, connect the MIDI cable to MiniFuse MIDI output and then to your instrument's MIDI input. This will allow the MIDI signal to travel out of MiniFuse and into your external hardware. Next, make sure you set your instrument's clock source to MIDI so that it's ready to receive information from the input. Now we'll adjust the settings in our DAW. In Ableton Live, we'll go to Preferences, then into the Link Tempo MIDI tab. Here, you'll see which MIDI ports are available, so we enable MiniFuse input and output. Now we're ready to create an external instrument track inside Ableton. This track will combine MIDI information and the audio coming from your instrument. To use it, go to the Instruments tab and simply drag and drop. Now we'll pick the MiniFuse 2 output as the MIDI destination and we'll make sure the MIDI channel matches our external instrument. We're using MIDI channel 1. We also need to choose the audio input source, which in this case will be input 1. Now our setup is ready. To start controlling our external synth with Ableton Sequencer, simply create an empty clip and start programming notes like this. Once you're done, hit play and enjoy Ableton controlling your external device. MIDI can also be used to control plenty of other parameters on your hardware using what's called MIDI CC information. Many hardware instruments like synths and drum machines can use specific MIDI CC information to adjust things like filter cutoff using your DAW. To do this, simply enter the Envelopes tab inside of your clip. Then choose MIDI control and pick whatever parameter from the list that you want. Different instruments use different MIDI CC numbers to affect different things. For MicroFreak, filter cutoff is controlled using number 23. Now, if I draw an automation envelope like this, you can hear MicroFreak's filter cutoff changing according to the shape when I play back the clip. As mentioned earlier, we can use MIDI in the other direction so that our DAW is controlled by our hardware, like in this case, where we're using MicroFreak to control pigments. Any device that has a sequencer, keyboard, or arpeggiator can be used to control virtual instruments in your DAW. Simply connect the MIDI cable from your external device MIDI out to MiniFuse MIDI in port. Then make sure to set your external device clock back to internal. Inside Ableton settings, make sure to enable MiniFuse MIDI import in the MIDI tab. Then all you have to do is to create a MIDI track with your favorite VST on it, such as Pigments. Pick MiniFuse from the MIDI from list, arm the track, and start playing on your favorite external synthesizer. On top of playing, you can use a sequencer or an arpeggiator to trigger sounds too. Some sequencers, like this one in MicroFreak, have unique features like spice and dice, which can be used to inject interesting creative ideas into your virtual instrument sequences. And that's really it! As you've seen, MiniFuse 2's MIDI connectivity opens up a whole new world of creativity. You'll easily be able to come up with exciting music ideas and keep your instruments as connected as you need. For other tips on MiniFuse, make sure to watch our other tutorials and how-tos, and make sure you subscribe and leave us a thumbs up. Thanks for watching and see you soon.